All right. Hey, this is Agent 355, and today we're playing All the People I Know.
Hi, I'm also a person he knows.
This is a halfling team, similar to goblins, in that they're not very good. This is a tree.
He's wearing a basketball jersey.
Yeah, it's a tree.
It's a tree.
They're trees, so they're basically really hard to kill, very strong, and they don't move very much.
He had a bird's nest in his thing.
And this is what Flare looks like, IRL.
It's kind of close.
Do you wear pots on your head?
Sometimes. I mostly did that when I was a kid.
So this kind of surprised me. You see he has 820,000 inducements.
Yes.
I didn't expect that. I kind of expected him to have like a few hundred. Yes. When I saw 820, I kind of was like, oh, shit, this game's not going to go well for me.
Oh, wow, he got 2-star players.
So he got Morgenthorg and Zara and a halfling chef, so
we're going to... Those are all awesome. They're all really cool.
Yeah,
so we should talk about those.
Well, we'll kind of see them as it goes. Unsurprisingly, when very, very expensive star players tend to have the entire game sort of revolve around them, so...
That's Zora. She was on the opposite side of the trees, and the dude in the front was Morg and Thord.
While I get mad about this perfect defense preventing me from punching all of these delicious, squishy halflings, the way a halfling chef works is they roll 3d6, and for each die roll that's above 3, so a 4, 5, or a 6, I lose a reroll, and he gains my reroll. For everyone below, nothing happens. So in this case, he stole one of my rerolls, so he gets 1, and I only have 2. In a perfect world for him, he would steal all 3 of my rerolls, leaving me with none while he had 3.
Also, only halflings get 3 dice, I think.
The difference for halflings is this: the chef is cheaper.
Oh, okay.
It only costs, I want to say, 100 or 150, instead of like 300. It's normally a very expensive inducement, but for halflings, it's relatively cheap.
Okay, and they're basically expected to have one every game.
Yes, that's pretty much normal.
Because so, halflings are not worth a lot of money.
No, they're not. So, halflings are similar to goblins in that they're stunty and they all have dodge. And they all have very low armor. They don't move very far. In fact, honestly, I don't know why anyone would ever play halflings.
Because they're fun.
I guess. I don't know. I'm not a big fan. Like, I like goblins. I do not like halflings.
I'm actually really upset you didn't show our guy's fancy new mutation. I think you should do that in videos from now on.
It will be in the video. Shut the fuck up. No, I'm serious. It is. You're just...
I'm just trying to find things to make fun of you for.
You're a whiner and a complainer. And I think you need to get your head in the game.
My head is just in the game. Like, I just saw a lineman block a halfling, and he got double pushes. There you go.
Yeah, the way halflings survive for any length of time is by you not knocking them down. That's about it, because if you knock them down, they're going to die, because they're only armor value 6.
And then the roger comes in.
I'm thinking about surfling that halfling, but I decided that that's probably not the wisest use of the roger, so...
See, this is why you don't understand or want to play halflings, because halflings are teams where you go in expecting to lose but have fun, and you like to win. I mean, it's kind of simple. You do like to win.
Well, it's true, but I also can lose and have fun with, like, say, goblins. It's just halflings lose. They don't even have fun while they're losing, because they can't chainsaw people. They don't get to throw bombs at people. You just have trees, which kind of slowly move around and punch people, and halflings, which slowly move around and die. I don't quite get it.
You can throw the halflings.
Oh, that's true, but you can throw goblins, too.
Can you throw goblins?
Of course.
Oh, yeah, that's right. The troll can throw other goblins.
The troll throws goblins.
Yeah. I just never really thought about it that way.
So I'm moving that guy over there, because if he's even one space onto their side of the field, he can just run to the end zone.
Yes.
So that's what he's there for.
And this is the prima donna.
And I'm trying to make him fairly safe. I don't want him to get punched, and so I'll kind of just put my punch gunners over here. So no biggie. And then I decide Hey, who wants to punch a tree? Roger.
Roger wants to punch a tree.
So let's pick up the ball and make it kind of safe before we go punch trees.
It's cool. That's a 2+ roll. He's got it.
Now, when I played Goblins, as you may recall, everything went very silly.
Yes. Is this going to happen again?
No.
Is that a lie?
No.
It's a lie.
No, it's not. This actually... I actually had to do quite a bit of editing for this, because you notice that my time right now is already below 2 minutes.
Yes, I see that.
A lot of turns go under 2 minutes, because this game is not nearly as one-sided as the other one was.
Oh, so it's giving you a decent challenge. I bet it's because I'm... I bet I do
good it's, things. It is. It's because you're on the team. Actually, it's because of those two star players. Right. I mean, and trees aren't horrible. I don't like trees as a general rule, but they're not bad.
Oh, we're
also doing here. We're zooming in. Look, see his claw. See his big claw.
Yes.
That's what claw does when you get a mutation on a Stormbrimmer.
Oh, I was looking at Morgenthurg.
Oh, I was talking about the Stormbrimmer. Well, no, as a show Morg too. You can see his big hook hand. He's a pirate, clearly.
Yes, he's a pirate.
The Stormbrimmer has a big claw too.
He's Marg and Thorg. Get it? R. Marg and Tharg. I'm doing the thing where the pirate like flexes his arm inwards and closing one eye when I say it.
Oh, it's a pirate. I get it now.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So, one of my goals of this game is, of course, the Stormvermin are very good at killing halflings just because they have block. They don't need anything except block. And one of our Stormvermin actually has a.
Mighty Blow.
Yeah, Mighty Blow. So he's evil. Uh-oh.
No, Gargle Blaster, no!
He's fine. Didn't break armor.
He's fine.
Whew. And so, and one of our Stormvermin actually has Claw, which means he actually hurts both Morg and Trees like they were freaking goblins. It's great.
Freaking goblins.
Except he has to knock them down, because Morg does have 6 strength. Oh, and if you're curious what makes Morg so good, 6 movement, so he's reasonably fast. He's actually the fastest player on the halfling team, because all the halflings are 5 movement. Here's a shot of Morg. There we go.
He's got a little skull and crossbones. He really is a pirate.
He's got 6 movement. He's got 6 strength, which is huge. He's got 3 agility, meaning he can actually reasonably dodge. He has block. Now, it's important that star players have block, because they also have loner, like any other mercenary. So, you don't want him to throw bad blocks. He actually will throw good blocks. He will only turn over very rarely.
Also, he has AV-10.
Also AV-10. I think he means 7. So it's him with claw.
Well, yeah, with claw, but normally it's 10.
Get clawed. So he... Now, this is who am I playing? I'm playing Arbitrary TA. Now, Arbitrary yes. TA said before the game started that he did not expect to win at all. He did, however, want to play like a horrible person and kill all of my dudes, which is why you see him ganging up here for a foul.
Well, that's a good desire, and I support him as he continues in this endeavor.
It is. It is good. I mean, Nope.
Also, that's the other star player there, but we haven't zoomed in on her yet.
Now, well, Zara is going to be obnoxious for a completely different reason. She isn't as strong, and she does have stab, but I don't think she actually even uses it. The reason Zara is obnoxious as all get out is because she has blodge.
Which is block and dodge.
Block and dodge, and so I punch the fling there, because again, the gunners have block too, which means the gunners are actually good at killing flings.
Oh, that's our blodging gunner there, Mr. Johnny.
Yep, we have 2 blodge gunners. We have 2 blodge gunners and a wrestle gunner.
Why have we been giving you such good skills?
Because you guys are... Because I think what it... Like, honestly, like, real talk. It's because in Knorr's LP, people started out not giving them good skills, and then realized very quickly it wasn't as much fun watching a team just lose all the time.
This is fair, but we've given you a lot of good skills. I think we could go for some stupid shit now.
The only thing I want is I want my plus agility guy to end up with wrestle or block next level. Because if he doesn't, I'm going to start running into a lot of teams that can kill me. And it's going to be awful.
Just awful.
Just awful.
Also, this isn't going to come up in this game. So I'm going to mention it now because it's something that really rarely comes up. What's her name?
Zara.
Zara. She has a second special skill that makes her stabs more effective against, like,
Underworld. Claw on a tree. Ugh.
Claw on a tree.
And I failed to break armor. God damn it.
But yeah, just as she also has a thing that makes her stabs more effective against, like, I forget, it's like necromantic teams.
Undead.
But
undead team. Yeah. Yeah, she gets a +1 to stab. So basically her stabs have mighty blow versus undead people.
But we're never going to see that, so I felt it would be fair to mention that now.
Yeah,
just so
probably not going to come up.
Also, Leap is about to happen.
Ready?
Ready
Grace.
Woo!
Yeah.
Such Ratty Grace!
So then I'm looking at the spaces, and I'm like, do I benefit from being two more spaces away? And the answer I came up with is yes, I do, so I better make those going forwards.
He does, like, a triple front flip, and then he lands in a pirouette.
See, I wanted the flat halflings to have to actually make an effort to punch me.
Right. He did it!
Yeah, he did it.
We did it! Woo! We did it!
No, let's not go there.
Aww.
But no, but Zara has Blodge, and so Zara is going to be a huge pain in the ass this entire first half. You're going to watch. She's going to be everywhere I don't want her to be, and I hate her.
Aw, but I bet she likes you.
No, I'm pretty sure she doesn't. She tries to kill me.
Does she try to kill you, or does she try to kill your rats? Because there's a difference.
No, there isn't. I am my rats. The blood of the rats flows within me.
This is getting creepy.
You're the one who started to sing Dora the Explorer songs.
Look, that's only creepy if you make it creepy, because she got me through like 2 years of Spanish education.
Yeah, this is interesting. I'm already having way more trouble this game than I expected, because really the having 800 in inducements really took me by surprise. It really
Wait, did. Damn it. What did he do wrong? Wait, oh, he did
meant
blitz.
To blitz. He meant to blitz, and I asked blitz with this guy.
Ooh, and he rerolled.
Don't die.
His single reroll.
Speedy!
He's fine.
He's stunned. He's safe for one round. Well, until he gets stomped.
He's taking a nap.
It's one thing I haven't seen either of the stunty coaches do that I did as a stunty coach. Knock down someone with 7 armor value, you put like 3 goblins on them, and you stomp on them until they're dead.
Oh.
I would absolutely dodge out those halflings and stomp the hell out of my players. Because
did they even get there?
Yeah, they're for moving 5. The only problem is they'd have to dodge away from the Rat Ogre, I guess, would be the biggest issue. But yes, they can get there. So again, you can see how much thinking is going on, which is kind of weird for us.
Yeah, there's these pauses where people are thinking, like, what are we doing? What should I do?
And I didn't really expect that, to be honest.
Well, I mean, sometimes you just gotta take a smoke break.
The perfect defense kind of screwed. I shouldn't even say screwed me over, but kind of threw a wrench in the works because he started with just 3 halflings on the line, which I was going to punch easily. Ooh, please die.
Ooh, kind of close.
All of these names, by the way, these are people who hang out in the IRC a lot for the most part.
Yes. Except that does Washout hang out in the IRC?
Yes, he does. Washo does hang out in the IRC. Not so much ever since his LP. I do like the joke about the failed LP.
Now that is mean. Also, we don't have someone named Claw Palm in the IRC.
No, that's I'm trying to think what I want to do here.
Roger, kill Zora.
Good old Roger.
What the. Okay, that was a weird graphical glitch.
Yeah, that's going to happen a lot. For whatever reason, this pitch does that a lot.
Okay, I was not aware of that, but that's good to know. You could surf that halfling if you put that gutter runner on the other side. Do it past age. Aww.
No, I want to. Who do I blitz? Oh, that's right. I want to kill Zara. I'm like, die.
That would be such a waste of team value.
You can see the tackle zones on the pitch continually coming in and disappearing again.
Yeah, we can. What? I have no idea. But yeah, the ball. Yeah, see, now they're fixed. It's like when you move the camera up, they break.
Yes, that is exactly it. And I'm like, oh, I can't really reach the ball, I guess. Can I get to the ball? I want to get to the ball. I want to pick up that ball.
See, Johnny's got very good grace at avoiding people ever since his the night of burning hammers.
Did you think this up while
No, I'm coming up with this straight off the fucking top of my head.
You didn't like write it down before?
No. Every time I mention something with Johnny, just right there, I'm just making shit up.
Okay. All right, we'll continue. Let's hear it out.
Okay, well, the Night of Burning Hammers. You've seen that movie, the one with Kaiser Soze, right?
No. Maybe. I don't know.
I forget the name of the movie. Get out. Basically,
Studman Dude Bro, KO'd.
Okay, basically, the Night of Burning Hammers was the night where Johnny's bag of hammers was lit on fire.
It doesn't seem all that traumatic. I mean, he hits people with it, right? So he just basically flame enchanted his weapon and adds an extra 1d6 of fire damage.
You know, that would be true, except that those hammers were a gift from his dear old dad.
George!
Like, when they burned, it was like burning up his past and his only remnant of his father, who died in a terrible... And remember, they're dwarves. He died in a terrible dwarven bread accident.
I see you read Discworld. Now you're stealing from Discworld.
You know what? I steal from a lot of things.
Really? Because I thought you came up with Night of Burning Hammers all on your own.
Well, see, I was gonna.
Don't stab me! Oh crap! She just blocked me regular. Well, the funny thing is, actually, against the gunners, stab is way more likely to knock me down than just.
Yeah, but it's okay. She got the ball. Oh no, she don't. Nope. She don't got the ball.
Nope. But actually, stab's more likely to knock me down than a pow, because a pow is only going to happen on 11 out of 36 blocks.
Right.
While a stab will actually break armor about 47% of the time, so it actually is more likely.
The Roger should blitz her, and then a gutter runner should pick up the ball.
I really want to. I want to blitz her. So I'm thinking. I'm like, well, I can kind of blitz her, but I can't, because he might have to go in for it, and I don't trust him. So I'm doing the math. I'm saying, okay, she has 4 strength. Gutter runners are 2 strength, and that means it would take every last one of my gutter runners to punch Zara off the ball.
Right.
So I say, okay, if I move my Roger up first, then it won't take all of the gunners to punch her off the ball, which means I can punch her off the ball and then pick it up later.
Unless you wild animals. Aww.
So, okay, so now, in order to pick up the ball, I'm going to have to blitz and pick up the ball in the same action.
Okay.
Which means these blocks down there against all those halflings are not as safe as I would like them to be.
Right.
So I can't make them right now. I have to just punch her.
Do it, Pangolastic Gargoyle Blaster! Please be dead. It's okay. You can still throw a touchdown.
Yeah, now I can score easy, so I'll just pick it up and walk in. I thought about stalling, and then I figured, no, we're not going to do that.
No, that would be mean.
Well, no, because I might score more touchdowns this half.
Oh, yeah, or that. I do like the new color scheme, though.
Yeah, someone suggested the yellow, and I'm like, yeah, sure, why not? I didn't mean to pick the other one, so.
Yeah, I think we should maybe, like, I think we should change every couple of games. I think you should go ahead and see if someone wants to change it after this.
I'm not sure about every couple of games. That's a little too often.
Well, it only takes like 5 seconds.
Well, no, it's not that. It's that you have an image. What about my branding? What about all of the merchandise I have made up in yellow?
Okay, look. If you want your rats, who already smell extremely foul, to smell even worse because they're wearing the same uniforms every last game.
I said we couldn't wash them.
I had assumed you. What are they going to play in while you're washing those uniforms?
Spares? Do you only have one shirt?
Yes.
Laundry day is terrible at your head.
Laundry day is terrible. Why do you think I can't afford a new microphone? I only have one shirt.
Oh. Now this,
I can't afford a new chair either.
Now while we're speaking of silly things, I see him mark the Storm Vermin with a Halfling, and I'm like, oh, well, clearly he's going to blitz that Storm Vermin with Morg. Then he marks the other Halfling. I'm like, wait, he can't blitz both of them. Does he just want to give me free Halfling punches? The answer is yes. He wants to give me free Halfling punches, which
isn't he nice?
Which is very nice of him. He's trying to get he's trying to get me SPP.
That's nice of him.
Fun fact, well, not that fun, but as the game progresses, and it was a much better game than I thought it was going to be. Like I said, I really thought it was going to be just kind of another stupid goblin game, and it wasn't. And as the game progresses, I spend less and less time looking at the dice log and more time just talking with the guy because things are happening.
Mm-hmm. You do keep, of course, the good lines, right?
The good lines?
Well, I mean, it's kind of unfair to us that we don't get to see you talking to him.
I'm not intentionally cutting anything out. The only times that things inadvertently get cut out is when I'm editing because not that much is happening on the pitch at any given time.
Hmm.
So it should be noted, I have a couple of players I want to score with. Yes. Some of the gunners are getting close to another level, so I'd like to get them another level.
Or you could do Roger Ball.
Or I could do Roger Ball. He would level up. Both the Storm Vermin are not close to leveling up, but hey, these guys are so easy to hurt. A couple, 2, 4, 6 SPP would be a big help.
Yes. And then you want to keep the linemen away from anything important as much as possible.
Yeah, if I can keep them from dung, that's great. I have a loner lineman, so. Alright, now Zara's got the ball. Now again, she has Blodge and 4 strength. This means I'm going to actually have a very difficult time getting the ball away from her, because I don't have any strip ball.
Oh, wah. Oh, also...
Kill it!
Oh, yeah, close.
Kind of. Half-killed.
Okay. Half-killed.
Bloodbot's funding.
He's only mostly dead. So, another thing that... I really like star players. They're cool guys. Mm-hmm. Like, I like them. So I like to talk about star players.
Okay, that's fair.
It is also not generally considered good Blood Bowl strategy to score with your star players because they don't keep the experience.
Right.
Except for Amputt.
And special. Anything you score with star players is just wasted. Yes. Look at how well-behaved this Ruger is.
He is. He's very well-behaved. I guess Johnny Bag of Hammers keeps him in line.
Yes, he must. Well, the rover's so big, he has huge kneecaps to break.
Yeah, I mean, it's just like a giant target.
Imagine how painful that would be.
Oh, God, unbearably. Why do you think he hobbles like he does, you know? Like, I imagine what happened is the roger, like, came charging into the locker room one day, and Johnny was just sitting there minding his own business, you know, polishing his bag of hammers, and the roger got right up in Johnny's face and just roared really loud. And Johnny looked up and he said, "You don't want to do this, buddy." And then the roger roared again, and Johnny broke his kneecaps, and the roger listens to Johnny now. And they go out for ice cream after every game.
And that's why the Roger only has 6 movement instead of 7.
Yes.
Got it.
Yep.
I'm pushing some flings.
Yeah, you are. But you're doing nothing but pushing
them. No, I'm just pushing them around a bit and KOing them sometimes.
Like, I mean, if they were... Oh, poor Lenny.
Lenny just wants some SPP.
Like, if they were dying, I'd talk about them dying, but, you know, pushing around halflings, it's kind of like beating up an 8-year-old. It's like, okay, that's boring.
I'm looking forward to... Everyone likes playing against flings or goblins. Everyone loves it. Yeah. You understand that things could go horribly wrong and everything will become terrible very quickly. You understand. That's just par for the course. Right. However, you're also very likely to get some good SPP and some touchdowns, and they're kind of like nice, easy games where a lot of other games take a lot more effort.
Right.
So, who doesn't like nice, easy games? But half the time in fling games, or ogres, or goblins, or any other stunt, or even with lizards focusing on the skinks, half the game is spent just trying to kill them.
Yeah. And if you fail, it's a boring game. But if you succeed, those are the games.
Those are the games. Oh.
Ooh. Who's that? Nothing but a good attack. Doc,
time to think of a new rat name.
Oh, Doc.
I like how it was a fling that did it. Not even any... These Mighty Blow trees ain't got shit, but flings, man. Flings will mess you up.
Some little spiky boots. Well, why do you think Johnny's staying so far away from them flings? He's smart. He knows what's going on.
Put the boots in. So I like someone suggested Colby Jackknife, which I thought was pretty good.
Wait, are people aware that this guy is dead?
Someone suggested that last time for another.
Oh, okay.
So I thought that was good.
Yeah, that sounds good. At least it wasn't the one that's already got a permanent injury, because I want him to stay around.
That is Fedda Off Dead.
Fedda Off Dead. I want him to actually be Fedda Off Dead.
Right. Eventually. That would be great. No, that one was just nothing but a Gouda Time, which was just kind of an okay name.
It's okay. We fed him to the Roger. Yeah. We got to keep him hung. We got to keep him, you know, sated and happy.
Well, no, but I thought you're supposed to keep him hungry, because that makes them better players. You know.
Dude, I do not advocate animal cruelty, even for Rogers. So, just keep me out of this. I don't want to be...
I already docked his ears. I mean, am I going to jail now?
I don't know, but you might. But he might end up on one of those what's-her-face commercials with the lady. In the arms of an angel!
Oh, God! Oh, God, I know exactly what you're talking about now. This is stupid. We have stupid conversations,
but I think I think people enjoy them. I mean, nobody's like told me that they don't enjoy our conversations.
So I almost didn't want to take this POW because I wanted to put the Roger onto Zara, but I decided. Mm-hmm. I mean, what else are you gonna do? You just take what you can get. Also, right. The Roger's got Mighty Blow too, so he's also particularly good at killing flings.
Yes.
And. Of course, what I want to do, though, is I got my Storm Vermin over there with Mighty Blow, and I really want to blitz flings with him.
Right.
So I'm trying to find a fling I want to kill, and I'm looking, and I have not actually, believe it or not, I haven't actually noticed their names yet at this point.
Really?
Yeah. I've been playing so far, I have not actually noticed that their names are silly, to say the least.
Okay. When did you notice this?
Well, I noticed, I want to say in like later in this half, maybe in the second half, you'll actually see me walking around clicking on all the people. And then I was like, oh, wait a minute, these guys have funny names. And then I realized that you were on their team, so I spent half the game trying to kill you.
Oh, wow. Wow, really?
Yeah. Well, of course. I mean, if everything else is equal, what fling do I want to blitz more? Flare Knight or any other fling?
Furl, you want to bling, you want to... Blitz Furl. I can't fucking say his name.
Furl's a tree. I can't do anything about Furl.
Ooh, I guess, smash collarbone.
Yeah, so smash call. So that's a one strength fling now, which is good. And that's also 2 SPP for our good friend. Why did I take a push there? Oh, that's right, because that's my leaf guy. He doesn't have block.
Yes.
See? Doesn't have.
I don't know why you pushed him that way.
Next to the rogue.
Oh. Okay, dodge, yes.
He's next.
I like how...
He's next to the Roger and next to the Storm Vermin. The Roger should keep him from dodging, and the Storm Vermin should be good at beating him up.
I like how you moved all your players to one side of the pitch, and then the star player ran halfway across the field to the other side of the pitch, and all your rats just, like, moved perfectly into position that way too.
Yeah, it's really hard to throw a reverse against rats. They're so fast that it's really hard for me to overcommit to one side. I can quite easily go back the other way.
Cut. I saw the cut.
Against slower teams, like say orcs, it's actually a very effective tactic. You might go mostly one way, and if they put all their dudes on one side, you just go the other way, and all of a sudden they're trying to chase you, and it's not going to work because they're so
strong. Right.
But with rats, I'm just too fast for that. I can't really.
Too fast for that bullshit. Oh, that's right. Now I get why you chose yellow. Because they're Zoom. I bet you don't even know who that is, do you?
Nope.
Flash villain. We're back to
comics. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, I know Flash. I don't read DC. I don't like DC.
No, see, I don't actually read comics that much either. Because, like, I have a terminal fear of going outside. And
well, you're a goon, so that just kind of goes without saying.
It goes with the territory. I have a terminal fear of going outside, and to get comics, I'd have to travel down like the main street of my town, mm-hmm. turn off into a little side alley to the comic shop. Then I'd have to come out and go all the way across the main street, which is like 5 lanes of traffic, And it's really a hassle, and I don't like going outside, so I just don't go and get comics anymore.
Oh, that flings down.
Poor fling.
All right, so ready to see some sweet-ass chain pushing?
I am ready to see some sweet-ass chain pushing.
Zara has Blodge, which we've been over. Do you know how you combat Blodge? You can there's exactly one way to combat Blodge.
Okay.
That is to throw a lot of block dice at Zara. A lot.
Right. Okay.
So I'm gonna.
You want to block her like a hurricane?
Yeah, block her like a hurricane. So I'm gonna use this Roger, and I'm gonna throw two at her. And I'm gonna push her up this way.
Right. You're gonna push her that way.
Yeah, that's the way. Push her that way, and then throw another two, and that didn't work. So I'm gonna.
You're gonna push her that way.
Yeah, I'm gonna push her up there now. And now, this lineman can go ahead and. Punch fling off.
Can do something. Yep. Punch the fling.
Punch the fling.
Fling goes bye-bye.
Yeah, you always hope it dies, but it doesn't really matter. Well, he's going to go over there. So now I have a 1 dB right now.
Right.
Or no, I'm sorry. A negative. I can get a 1 dB with a couple of assists.
Yes.
So that's kind of what I want to do. So I'm like, okay, well, if I get a 1 dB and I push her down, then the other gunner runner... can punch
foul.
Well, no, if I push her down, the other gunner runner will get a 2 dB.
I thought you meant push her down as in, like, to the pitch.
No, I'm sorry. I meant down as in,
Well, no, that's just, like, bad terminology for me. Whee! Ready, Grace.
So I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to get a 1 dB to get it. Oh, I knocked her down. This is good.
Now you're
all going to scatter.
Oh!
She's dead!
You killed her?
Well, not really, but she's dead. She's gone.
Well, she's dead for... Get O out. You see, I should... Wait, did you...
Now, with any star player, you cannot use your apothecary on them.
Yes.
Because the joke is they have their own apothecaries, so you can't actually use yours.
Well, that's but theirs always works. It's just that it doesn't work for your game.
So I'm like, okay, well, I have one more turn. I better put someone in scoring position. Get over there, Johnny.
And he's just gonna stand. And George's just gonna stand there with all the cute little halflings.
Yeah, I want to stand near a halfling just to prevent it from moving around. But I also don't want to get tree blitzed, so I stay way over here.
He just wants to give him hugs.
The good old 1 dB pow badly hurt.
Planned it like that. All magic. Planned.
I was hoping just throw enough block dice at her to eventually knock her down. It's just the fact that the 1 dB knocked her down was funny. And then killed her, which was great.
Yeah. She did.
That's a big difference. This is probably the point where this game went from reasonable to, okay, I got this now. We're good. We're fine.
Seems like you got some things going on here.
Get more mighty blow. Oh, god damn it.
Dang it, George.
The single most depressing block.
The single most depressing block.
And then something fun happens. Do you know what happens?
I don't know what happens. I'm going to watch and see.
Well, stupid fling. Well, you see how you got Morg right there, and I have all of these rats around Morg?
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna claw him.
Oh. Oh, fuck. Ooh. Are you going to stomp him, too? Well,
I'm not gonna stomp him, because I'd rather score. But yes. And then he says, oh, fuck, I just saw Johnny up there.
Johnny's good at hiding, All that time in the mob, you gotta blend into the background, Also, yeah, gonna score too, but claw more.
Hey, I got a reroll.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, well, I better do the handoff first. There. Now Johnny can score without rolling any dice whatsoever. He can just run in. Got to get lots of assists.
There's a point where assists stop mattering, and that's when you have every square filled with assists.
I can get one more, but I have no player, so I'll have to throw.
And it's still not enough for a 3-dice block.
No, you'd need 13 strength to get a 3-dice block on Morg. Come on, claw. Claw.
He's down. He's stunned. Didn't even need Claw.
Which is kind of a shame, really. I really wanted to kill him, because if I could kill both of those guys in like two turns, that would have made a pretty large difference.
Johnny.
But as it is, unsurprisingly, Rats are up 2-0. Surprisingly, the Flings are being rather difficult, even.
Yeah. No serious injuries yet.
Well, just that one.
that guy. That guy doesn't count, though. And nobody liked that guy anyway.
And okay, we got some Flings back, but we'll see how the second half goes. Yes. I predict hilarity.
You've still got like 5 minutes on this video.
Do I?
Yeah.
Oh, that's... Oh, what am I just talking about? It's not over yet. The half's not over yet. That was my turn 8, not his turn 8.
Yeah. Did he get a riot?
That's some weak-ass commentary. Yeah, this is right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just a retard who forgot he had a chance to one turn here.
Yeah, okay.
That's why all my dudes are set up in the back.
Yeah. Now see, in theory, I can still totally score.
Which is true, except he forgot to leave a fling back to pick up the ball.
Oh, yeah.
He thought he could pass and then throw a fling, but throwing a fling also takes is a pass action, and so you can't throw two passes.
Right.
You can pass a player or you can pass a ball, but you can't pass both.
You can pick your nose and you can pick your friend's nose. Wait, no, that's not how that saying goes at all.
It is now. And so, And so he can't. So he thinks he can. He's actually going to spend a reasonable amount of time thinking about how he's going to do this before he realizes that he set up wrong and he can't do it at all.
Huh. Now, he could have, if he had, he could hand off if he had a halfling back there.
Right. He could hand off to the fling next to the tree and then throw that fling down the pitch and then run that fling in. That's how you're going to teach. That's how you're going to pull off the TTM.
Right.
So I'm just referring to the different linemen as totally safe.
Mm-hmm.
All I want is for my linemen to live through this punching.
Right.
This is probably the scariest part for Skaven, because the more line rats I lose, the better players I have to put on the line, and the chance of the better players dying goes up.
Right. Sometimes scoring can be a bad thing. Welp.
Who needs dodge or block? I just wanted him to roll skull pushes all the time.
Yep. These three rats are completely surrounded, you know, like on all sides, nothing but spiky little boots and giant trees and that one pirate guy breathing down their necks, but they don't falter. They watch out for their own. Ratty brotherhood. Rathood? Rattyhood?
Band of Rathood.
Band of Rathood.
Look at skull push, even worse than a skull push.
Saving Private Rathead.
Uh oh, flings are deadly. Watch out.
Spiky boots.
All right, now where's the foul coming in? Because again, there it is.
Womp.
Didn't work, but you should be throwing those like every turn. Every single turn you should be throwing those.
Well, what happened is that lineman that's standing up like dove on top of his buddy and took the foul for him.
I think you're taking this too far.
Jeez. Well, if they were more dead things, we could make... Okay, now it's halftime. Now you can say halftime.
Now it's halftime. No real injuries except that guy.
Oh, and those two guys.
And the Flings got up and Zara, and we'll see what happens next time.
Yay. Okay.